Julianne Moore talks a lot about him. Why are you laughing?
I'm not laughing. I'm just scratching my nose.
Playing. Okay. So,
I think just in general, people should watch the film. And if they watch it and draw some judgments about it that are specific, I'd love to. We'd all love to hear them. But I think it doesn't make, it doesn't, it doesn't, it's better to wait until people have seen it. I don't know if they comment on it. There wasn't any at all, in part because we had the same vision for what the film should be. We wanted it to be accurate, and we wanted it to reflect the major game-changing moments that are in the book. We all agreed on that. And the people we worked with from HBO and the screenwriter Danny Strong and the director Jay Roach were all incredibly nice people. And there are two stereotypes that were exploded. One was that you sell your book to Hollywood and they make a mockery of it. That didn't happen. And the other is people in Hollywood are hard to deal with. Everybody we dealt with was very easy to deal with. So no, it was all a very pleasant, happy experience. I'm sorry for the sake of you wanting conflict in the narrative, but there wasn't any. I met her at the state fair in Palmer, Alaska, in fact, before she was governor even.
I love it. Oh my God, I think it's fantastic. You know, I mean, we're all extremely proud of it, and I think the actors are unbelievable. I think Jay Roach did an amazing job, and you know, just excited about it.
What's the biggest challenge of getting it from a book into a screen?
Well, I think, you know, any adaptation has its own specific challenges. In this case, you're dealing with a modern political story of people that are alive, people that are going to criticize the film. And it's sort of our duty and our goal is to get the story as accurate and truthful as possible. And in translating that into a film, it creates obstacles. Because in a movie, if things aren't working or the movie's kind of slowing down, well, you can just make it up and figure it out and fix it. But in this, you can't do that. The only thing you can use are the events that really transpired. But the flip side of that is you're only making the movie because the events that really transpired are so fantastic that they're worthy of being a film. So the film is extremely accurate. You know, like, it's not a word-for-word recreation of what happened, but, you know, Steve Schmidt, who's the lead character, saw the movie and said, that's true. That's what I lived through. So I don't know how you can do much better than that. These were all our first choices. I mean, who else could be a better John McCain than Ed Harris? You know, it was sort of like, I was talking about Ed Harris in the screenwriting, in the earliest stages of it, because he just kind of is John McCain. I mean, he's quite a bit younger than him, but you can age someone up, and we did, and he looks unbelievable. Well, you know, Julianne Moore jumped on board really fast, and it was really exciting, you know? I mean, we sent her the script, and we got a call the next day saying that she wanted to talk to the director and wanted to engage, and you know, it was in many ways, I don't know if the film would have gotten made if she didn't do it. You know, it was a little bit Julianne Moore bust, which is kind of scary, right, when you just want your movie made. Well, I don't think Republicans are so against this movie. I think the only comments we've heard from so far are from Sarah Palin's aides, who work for Sarah Palin, and we've also heard from people around the McCain family, you know, John McCain, Meghan McCain, and Cindy McCain. But, you know, that's about it. And I think that, you know, I think all of them should wait till they see the movie. I mean, particularly the McCains, you know, I think they should see the movie before they come attacking it. You know, Jay Leno told John McCain that he came across great in the movie and like a gentleman and a man of honor. And, you know, McCain looked really surprised. So, you know, I don't expect them publicly singing a different tune after they see it, but I think that they will be probably pleasantly surprised at how the film portrays them.
Exactly the same. The movie is incredibly true to the book. And so, you know, we thought that Sarah Palin was a, like, every politician I've ever covered. She has incredible strengths, and she has some distinct weaknesses, at least which as a vice presidential candidate. You know, she performed under extraordinary pressure with very little preparation. She, at times, performed, like, way better than you could have ever expected anybody from her nomination, her initial announcement speech, her convention speech, in the debate after having had a really hard time in her preparation. She ended up rising to the occasion and dueling Joe Biden to a draw. You know, at the same time, she had some real significant substantive deficiencies and some temperamental ones. And those things are, you know, I've never covered a politician. I've been doing this for more than 20 years. I've never covered a politician where I couldn't find really significant flaws as well as really significant strengths, at least ones that get to that level. And that was the case for her, for sure.
Sometimes I would see real Sarah Palin on TV at night, and I would be disoriented. It became so much for us a kind of interpretation of that became a kind of having a spell cast on you on the set, because Julianne Moore, Ed Harris, they were so close to the people they were playing, and even Steve Schmidt, who I'd gotten to know through a lot of research. Woody Harrelson's capturing his body language, his way of carrying himself, and the things he cared about above all, you know, that stuff made us feel sometimes like we really were there. But then the bubble would break and we'd realize, oh, we're making a movie, but we'll be back tomorrow.
I don't see myself as a villain at all, no. I think Nicole is a woman with a very powerful moral compass and who had a great deal of patience dealing with, I think, a really intense situation where the stakes couldn't have been higher. So I think she's kind of a hero to me. Her patience alone, I would never have been able to do the same. I did not read her book because it didn't take, she had written it after the campaign and I didn't want to read the thing that had happened after the time and place that I was representing. Oh yes, I liked her very much.
Do you guys want to go together? We have to take her.
I learned a great deal by playing her. I think Nicole is, at least in my opinion, and from what I read and what I was able to ascertain about her, was a person who had the courage of her convictions and was incredibly smart and loyal and patient. So I learned a lot by playing her. About being a person in the world.
Did you get to actually hang out with her?
I did not. No, I never met her while I was shooting.
Has she reacted at all to the movie?
Not that I know of.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know.
No. This is a shallow question, but yeah. Do you dress more conservatively because it's like Washington, D.C. red carpet?
Oh, no. Does it look that way? I'm buttoned up. Well, but when you have a belt like that, why would you not want to wear that?
That's true. It's pretty fantastic.
How can you not wear that belt?
Thanks, guys. We got a great
question. So I think obviously the hardest thing is the most
thank you. After
thank you.
Like, you're never, ever going to be that person. You're not dressed. So you can try to approximate it as close as you can. But you remember that you're doing within this framework, in this particular story. So,
Did anybody have a question again?
Did your opinion of Sarah Palin change over the course of making the movie?
I think that the movie is less about Sarah Palin than it is about our political process. You have to remember that it starts with her VP nomination goes all the way through the campaign. So it's about this group of people. Steve Schmidt, in particular, is the one who engineered the choice. If anything, I think what we take away from it is that, you know, why is it that we're so attracted to people who are incredibly attractive and charismatic and seem like movie stars? Why is that something we look for in our political leaders? I don't know that those are necessarily qualities that we need for the president or vice president.
Have you had much experience with campaign events? I mean, did you find it easy to put yourself into that setting?
Me? Yeah. No, I'm an actress. I'm not a politician. Of course. Yeah. I worked in the Mondale campaign years ago. Yeah, so.
Well, that's sad.
Yeah. What?
Did you look to Tina Fey at all for any inspiration?
I didn't, because I knew we were going to have that moment in the movie, so I didn't look at any
inspiration. Have you been paying attention to the 2012
campaign? Your shoes. They are dressed.
Yeah. 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 Thank you.
Have you been watching the 2012 presidential race?
A little bit, yes.
And your thoughts on that?
Not going to give you my thoughts on that. I think that, yes, I mean, there's certainly a lot of information that I gather just about what the process is and how I just thought it was going to be more organized. I really did. I really didn't ever... You don't know when you're watching on television they're actually moving from one hotel to the next every single day. You don't realize that they're writing scripts, they're writing, you know, speeches on the fly. You know, you don't consider that the ground is shifting underneath them every single day. You know, that kind of campaigning, those kind of pressures, it's something that I just hadn't thought about before, didn't know about.
I want to know, when you're out publicly, do Sarah Palin fans come up to you, talk to you at all? Do they like you?
No, nobody comes up to me.
No,
the movie's not out yet.
Well, I think it's been in the press for months, though. I mean,
yeah. No, I think I look a very different person. No one's approached me.